Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very interesting video for you guys. I'm gonna be doing a video where if everything in my collection disappeared, what are the things that I would buy right off the bat? No questions asked. Like, as soon as I find out, I'm going to Ulta, that kind of thing. So I hope you guys like this video. I'm not the first one to do this. I just wanna go and say that I got this inspiration from Jessica Braun. I think she got it from someone else. So if I can remember, I will try to link her video down below or in the comment section. I'll go and post it there. That way you guys know and you can check out her video. This is not a collab. This isn't anything. This is just simple inspiration from her video. So I hope you guys do enjoy it. Please be sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And also be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. That way you guys can stay a part of my little family we got going on here. Because I'd love to have you guys a part of this family. It would mean a lot to me. So let's just jump right into this video. Alright you guys, so the first thing that I would definitely pick up. I'm not going to go and keep saying that. I'm just going to, you know, usher it along. I would definitely pick up the Naked 3 palette. I just love pinks. They are timeless. They are perfect. They are my perfect nude is pretty much what a pink is. They are my perfect everyday natural kind of shade. Like literally, I probably would just not use this half and just use these. Like I would use the crease color, but I would just stick with these because they're just beautiful. My reasoning for wearing a lot of pinks on my eyes, they are more natural to my skin tone as opposed to browns or earthy tones. Earthy tones just don't seem to flatter my skin tone. They do kind of wash me out, I've noticed. I wore brown one time on a shirt and it didn't look good. It made me washed out. It made me look very pink. It just wasn't a very good look. I have a very cool skin tone, and so I definitely think that pinks are more my natural kind of color. That's why I would definitely pick it out. This would be like a staple. This is a staple, but mostly because this palette is all pink is why I pretty much say if I lost everything, this would be the first thing I'd pick up. So definitely would recommend this palette. And I just want to go ahead and throw out, I'm not going to go in any specific order. I'm just going to go ahead and just pull out whatever I have. So next, I would also pick up the Milani Romantic the flower blushes. I have the shade Tea Rose right here, which looks like that. And I also have the shade Romantic Rose, which looks like that, which is a very just, they are beautiful. I love a nice, good matte blush. I think it is timeless. I think it is, in any season, you can make a matte blush work. And especially with these, I also like to use these as eyeshadows. I love mixing these two into the crease. If you saw my Bridal Madness Monday, which I will be sure to throw up in the cards somewhere or sometime during this video, I love using these in the crease. I just think they are beautiful. They make green eyes pop. Pinks in general make green eyes pop, and I hazel eyes pop, and I do have hazel eyes. So I just think they're beautiful. And I feel like these specific blushes, like matte blushes, can work on any single skin tone. Skin type, like dry, oily, combo, acne prone. I just think like these are just like the perfect everyday kind of blushes to me. Sorry, I'm trying to make sure it not glares. I just think they're perfect and everyday friendly. Like this would be all I need. And I don't have to worry about them being too in your face because they're just the perfect amount of pink. They're just perfect. And you do need to build them up a little bit, which I do like, as opposed to one dip and you're like trying to really make sure you blend it in or else you're going to look like a clown, which no one likes. I would also pick up the Sweetest Bling Limited Edition Wet n Wild Highlighter. It looks like that. You guys, it makes me so upset that this is limited edition, and I kind of hate that I show it a little bit, but I can't stop using it. I do think they had, like, an edition that's somewhat close, but not exactly close, but, like, it's, like, almost in the same there. It's, like, there, but not there, you know what I mean? They have one. I think it's called Blossom Rose or Blossom Glow or some crap. I don't know. Some crap like that. But it's just the most beautiful, flattering, pink, peachy pink, no, it's peach, it's not peach, it's just a very flattering, cool tone pink highlighter, especially if you have a fair skin and you can't find anything that's very flattering on your skin tone, this would be something that I would recommend, like, hands down, no doubt in my mind, this kind of highlighter would just be perfect on pale skin tones, and I'm fair as, not as fair as I can get, but I'm pretty fair, and I definitely would pick this up if this was permanent, or I'd pick up the Blossom Glow if it was permanent. I would definitely pick it up. Alright, you guys, so I would pick up the Four Contour. I would hands down pick up the Toughest Taupe Maybelline cream eyeshadow. I love to use this as contour if you've been with my channel a long time. This is what it looks like. It's a very beautiful taupey kind of color. I think it's perfect for a nice shadow effect. I love this color. I think it is absolutely stunning. And if you're as fair as I am, you would probably like to use this. I don't like using contours that are brownish or whatever. I like to use a gray because the shadows are gray. They're not brown. They're gray. They're gray. Like, but in people's defense, you know, if they don't use like a brownish gray or like a taupey kind of color, they'd probably look very muddy. This doesn't look very muddy on me at all. I think it looks absolutely stunning. So I like when I pan this, because this is part of my project pan, I will get another one, like, probably that day. You know what I mean? Now, cream eyeshadows. I have two of them, three of them, but one of them is not with me. I would pick up Badge of the Bronze as one of them. I love this color. This is a everyday kind of color if I would wear this every day. It's just a very beautiful bronzy shade. I think looks good on every single... My cats are just being ridiculous. This looks good on every single skin tone. It doesn't matter if you're really deep and beautiful, or very fair and beautiful, or medium skin toned and also beautiful. Obviously, we're all beautiful. But I think this looks good on any age, any skin tone, any kind of oily lids, dry lids, whatever, wrinkly lids. I think, like, I put this on my mom and it was beautiful. It made her hazel eyes pop. I think any eye color can wear it, honestly. Blue, green, pink, you guys know what I mean. But this would, like, just look at this, you guys. This is just stunning. Ugh. Like, I'm panning this, and as soon as this goes, I'm buying another. Like, right off the bat. So, I also have another one that's by Wet n Color Tattoo. I mean, Maybelline. It's the Inked in Pink. It's just a straight-up kind of cool-toned kind of pink. It's not rose gold, but it is just a straight-up pink. I would pick up that one in a heartbeat as well. And I also have the Revlon Colorstay Cream Eyeshadow in the shade 730. This is just a very beautiful rose gold. Of course, you know me and rose gold. Love, love, love rose gold. It is my favorite kind of color, especially to put on the eyes. I think it's the most flattering throughout the whole range of skin tones. I think rose gold is the most flattering on every single skin tone. Every single skin tone, I believe, can wear rose gold. Because there's different shades of rose gold. There's ones that are more pink, like this one, or there's ones that are more warm, coppery, but, like, you can't tell if it's copper and gold, or if it's a rose gold, because it's so warm. So, I feel like it can look good on any single skin tone. So, for cream eyeshadow, I would, hands down, I would pick up the Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade in the shade ash brown. It is the perfect kind of shade for my brows. I am a very fair girl, and a lot of things that say ash brown are not ash brown. They are literally warm toned, or I don't know why, but they're warm toned, or they're too dark, or they're not ash brown at all. They're just a warm brown, which is not ash, no. So I think this is the perfect neutral color for my brows that actually matches my hair color. I think this one matches my hair color really well as well, but I definitely would pick this up, hands down, in a heartbeat. As soon as this is gone, I'm picking one up, like, regardless of, like, whatever. I will drive to get this stuff, hands down. I have two eyebrow pencils because sometimes I'm just lazy and don't want to mess with pomades. So I have the NYX Professional Makeup, NYX Eyebrow Powder Pencil, and it's in the shade Ash Brown. Same deal. I love the powder. I think it's very creamy. I think it blends beautifully onto the skin. I mean, onto the brows. I love it. Then I also have Sephora waterproof eyebrow pencil in the shade of Midnight Brown. Same deal. This is actually what I'm wearing in my brows today. I think it is a really good match for my natural hair color. I think it's actually really good. Like, I think so at least. Like, that's pretty much the closest you can get. And normally you do it lighter than your hair color, but I don't mind if it's, the same color. At least I know it matches and it's not like too warm. These are just pretty neutral kind of colors. They do pull a slight bit warm, but I do have some reddish, not reddish. I do have neutral hair. It can go either way. Sometimes it just depends on what color my hair is. Now, since my hair is so ashy blonde, it does look more cool toned than it does warm. So, but growing up in the light, I did have like reddish tints to it. You can definitely see that. For mascara, absolute fave. I could not choose. This is the Lash Paradise Lash Princess Essence Lash Princess Falsy Effect Mascara. This is what the wand looks like. This one's dried up, so it doesn't matter. Like, that's what the wand looks like. It's beautiful. I love the effect it gives. It makes my lashes really, really long. That none of these are the mascara I'm wearing today. I'm wearing the crappiest crap mascara. It's just because I wasn't going anywhere, so I said whatever. It doesn't matter. And then I just opened the same stupid one. And then we have the Lash Princess Volume Mascara. Beautiful. I love this one. And this is what the wand looks like. I think it is like, I love these wands. This gives a lot of volume. It makes my lashes look really, really long and black. Ugh. Love this mascara. Like, I know as soon as I finish up this one and I have a purple one down there, I am going to get more. Like, no doubt in my mind. Like, I am going to pick up another one. I don't know if they sell it in waterproof, but if they did, I would buy a waterproof to wear to my wedding. But I don't think they do. I don't think this is waterproof. It never said if it was, so I'm not gonna assume that it is. Oh, if you have a really good recommendation for waterproof mascara, let me down in the comments below because I do need a waterproof mascara for my wedding because, obviously it's very emotional, so I'm gonna need to know. So just leave that down in the comments below. Now for eyeliner, this one was kind of hard because I don't normally wear eyeliner. So for like liquid eyeliner, I would choose the Essence Cushion Eyeliner. I know in the beginning I didn't like it, but my mind has changed. I really do like it. I think it looks wonderful, and I think it's very nice, dark and black. You do have to use a fine tip brush. You can't use a slanted brush. I don't think it works with a slanted brush. So I just like it. I just love it. Yeah, I just wish this was waterproof. That's the only thing. I wish this was water. I wish this was waterproof. I would also. I. Oh Essence iHeart Color Intensifying Color Eyeshadow Base for eyeshadow primer. This is amazing. Amazing. I like for $3. You cannot go wrong. They have different skin tones. I think they have a more yellow one. They have a little bit darker one. But this one is the closest one that I can find to my skin. I could probably wear this as a concealer almost. But this one is really nice. I like how it goes on. It is more peachy looking. I do think it corrects, what's underneath. I just love this. I find myself not ne I have no creases in my eyeshadow. I don't have any issues with it, blending it, nothing. I do set it, which I'm going on to my next thing. My best friend gave this one to me. It's the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Translucent Powder. These two combos, perfection. Because I'll go ahead and put this, I'll pretty much color my whole eye in, blend it all out, and then I'll go right in right away with my finger, and I'll just tap it all over, and I really pack on that powder, and I find out my eyeshadow stays, the color stays, it doesn't crease, my lids don't get oily. Even if they do get oily or I'm sweating, my eyeshadow still is there, and I think that is a definite good thing. So these two are like, they are perfection in a bottle and a cartridge. Perfection. Last but not least, setting spray. This isn't like this specific one. This is just a type of setting spray. I love anything matte, pretty much. I do have oily skin. I mostly get oily like right in here. Like it's already oily right now, if you can tell. And up here, sometimes on my chin, but not really like over here on my sides. I do like I'm combo skin. So pretty much anything matte is pretty much what I go for. So it's not this specific one, it's this specific type. I will just pick up any sort of matte setting spray. And I think setting sprays do the job. I mean, I'll load my face up and my face is like matte for the rest of the day. If I do get oily, I'll take a little piece of paper, or a paper towel, and I just blot and I'll set everything again. I just find myself reaching for this, for matte setting sprays as opposed to my CoverFX Luminous one. I will use a Luminous primer if I really want it, and then I'll go in with a matte setting spray to kind of mix and match, and I think my skin looks flawless after I do all that. So. Alright, you guys, so that was the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you have any recommendations that you would love for me to try, pick up, remember, guys, I am on a budget, so I can't go out and spend, like, $200 on makeup. I would love to, but I can't. So, I hope you guys enjoy this video. And if there's some things that you like that I didn't mention, or, vice versa, if you hate it and I love it, it's okay. We have different skin types and skin tones and whatnot. We are all beautiful in our own ways. Remember that? We're all beautiful. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.